ahorita que me quieres a tu lado. Qué lindo sería si tú me das, te invito a que dejemos todo un lado. Que empieza la liga, yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí.
Well, it's La Liga time now on the Sports Max Zone, and of course brought to you by Omega XL. Round 31 of Spain's top flight concluded early on Thursday with three matches. In one of the early games, Villarreal took on Espanyol, who are fighting relegation. Villarreal themselves were looking to keep their spot to play in Europe next season.
With the corner, whips it in, it's headed away by Pau Torres. Drops again for Espanyol. Javi Puado with the strike, and he finds the top corner. We'll see it here again. Espanyol from their first corner of proceedings. It's headed away by Pau Torres. The ball drops down here. Puado is clearly onside. He is there again and goes for goal, but it is a question of whether Joselu or Cesar Montes touch the ball. Who? Almost everything goes through Parejo Villarreal, but here's Etienne Capoue! What a strike that is for Villarreal! But it is an exquisite effort from the Frenchman to beat Pacheco. And we can't reiterate this enough. Pacheco has been outstanding this evening. But finds Jeremy Pino against Puado. Lovely skill there from Jeremy Pino, back into the box. The shot! The deflection off the defender, and the Villarreal players asking for a penalty, as there may be a potential handball. The shot from Alberto Moreno, there's the skill from Lo Celso earlier on in the move. Jeremy Pino with the strike. From one angle it looks like it's a clear handball, from another it looks like it comes off the stomach of Cesar Montes, and the referee's decision is Dani Parejo, the Villarreal captain, has stepped up to take it, to try and give Villarreal the lead on his 100th La Liga appearance for the club. Up he steps, and it's saved, but the rebound is finished off. No changes yet as well from Quique Setién. Jeremy Pino tries to get round Puado, but this time the Espanyol winger, playing as a fullback there temporarily, wins the ball back, but Jeremy Pino was having none of it. Darder. Pau Torres just slips there. It's won back by Martin Brathwaite. He has Joselu in support. He picks him out, and there's the equaliser. Pau Torres just slips at the worst possible moment. Mandy clearly playing Joselu onside, and that is a striker's finish. Joselu, Espanyol's number 9. Lead to Martin Brathwaite, picking out Joselu for 2-2. Here's Nicholas Jackson in the box, brings it down very nicely, goes for goal! And he reinstates Villarreal's lead! And as soon as Cesar Montes backs off, gives him that extra yard, he does well to sort out his feet, and on his left foot, whipped in at the front post, helped on, and into the top corner. It's fairly poor defending from the corner. It's cleared away at the front post by, I believe, Oscar Gil, but it's straight into the path of Etienne Capoue, looking for a hat-trick as he picks out Alex Baena. Just look at that, 13 shots on target from Villarreal, as Simo wrestles Baena to the ground. Four of the 7 minutes of stoppage time have been played, but the referee now walks over and shows a straight red card to Edu Exposito. Looking for the volley out of nothing, really, as now the 7 minutes of stoppage time are up, and the referee for today's game, Mr. Cesar Sotogrado, blows his whistle.
All right, so Espanyol getting the lead lands, but, you know, not taking advantage of it. And we've spoken about this many times on this show, Villarreal, you know. They've been a really, really good team this season. They started this match in sixth position. Of course, with this win, they are moved up to fifth position. And I was making the comment to you off camera. If Real Sociedad don't watch themselves, there's just 5 points separating them from Villarreal, and they can easily climb into fourth spot with the amount of games remaining.
Yeah, and, you know, a good rebound for Villarreal because they were coming off two losses and badly needed a win here to, you know, maintain their push for a place in Europe. Some fabulous goals, and we saw that from the Yellow Submarine.
Yeah.
Effort there from Espanyol with Martin Brathwaite, the Danish player whose dad is from Guyana and had spent some time, of course, at Barcelona. He assisted on one of the goals for the beaten team here.
Yeah.
But Villarreal getting a good result and trying to, you know, push for a place in Europe. And as you said, overall they've had a pretty solid season. But
yes,
those, you know, positions between second and seventh, eighth at the moment looking tight in La Liga.
Definitely. And of course, a couple games left again. Round 32 gets on the way on Friday. Let's take a look at the fixtures, Lance, and see which ones look exciting. All right, so Osasuna at home to Real Sociedad, Elche play Rayo Vallecano, Real Madrid will be playing Almeria, Barcelona. Of course, they suffered a loss yesterday. I was really disappointed. They'll be up against Real Betis, Cadiz play Valencia, Villarreal up against Celta Vigo, Espanyol against Getafe, Valladolid play Atletico Madrid, Mallorca at home to Athletic Club, and Sevilla, they'll be seeing Girona. So, Lance, let's look at the table, and then I want to hear which matches you're looking forward. So, Barcelona at the top of the table, you know, 76 points, despite that loss they experienced yesterday. Real Madrid in second on 65. Atletico Madrid in sixth with 63 points. Again, Lance, that point we were making about how close the points are between second, third, and fourth. Real Sociedad on 55 points. Villarreal, after today's win, on 50. And Athletic Club, of course, that result today, they have 46 points in 7th position. In 10th spot, Girona on 41. All right, so, so Sevilla, of course, they would have played today to 41 points after that match. And in relegation zone, Getafe, Espanyol, and Elche.
Yeah, but Almeria, Valencia, and Cadiz not very far above the drop zone, so things pretty tight there for the relegation spots. We see Almeria on 33 points, and Getafe, the top team among the drop zone teams at the moment, on 31, so they were within two. So those teams just above there, from Valladolid down to Cadiz, not comfortable for them at all.
Not at all, and that just means we have to keep it locked to the remainder of the games to see how the La Liga table ends at the end of the season. Let's take a quick break and come right back.